Hey everyone, I'm Jay, and welcome to our Sophos Firewall API tutorial. In this video, we'll cover what is the Firewall API, how to authenticate with the Firewall API, and how to make API requests to the firewall. First, what is the Firewall API? Simply put, the Firewall API allows you to manage your firewall configuration programmatically. Instead of logging into your firewall's web UI interface and manually adding or removing configuration, you can use code to automate these tasks. Before we start the Firewall API demo, let's understand how it works. The Firewall APIs use XML payloads with custom tags for data exchange. These tags are included in the HTTP request body and sent via the HTTP POST method. For creating an IP address object, the API payload contains XML tags. The outermost tag is the request tag, which encompasses all other tags and marks the beginning of the request. The login tag is used for API authentication. The set tag is used for creating or updating configurations. It contains the desired changes to the configuration. To add a new IP address object, you can pass the information within the set tag. Detailed information can be found in the API documentation, which we'll explore shortly. The Firewall API offers support for various XML tags with different functionalities. Set tag with operation type add. This tag is used to create a new resource, such as rule configurations, policies, and others. By specifying the operation type as add within the set tag, you can indicate the intention to create a new resource. When updating a resource, such as rule configurations or policies, you can utilize the set tag with the operation type set as update and specify the desired changes within the set tags. To retrieve data from the firewall, such as firewall rules, interfaces, or other information, you can use the get tag. The remove tag is used to delete or remove a resource. There are other tags used in conjunction with these examples, serving purposes like resource filtering and authentication. These tags enhance the API's functionality and flexibility. Now, to start using the Firewall API, there are two prerequisites. First, you need to create an API user with appropriate read-write permission for the modules you want to update. And second, you need to allow the IP addresses in the firewall to allow those API calls. There are a couple of ways you can make the request or API request in specific using the curl command. There are other tools which you can use to send this request. First, if you're sending a simple API call or request, you can use the query parameter field to pass the entire payload or XML payload in the HTTP header. In this example, I'm sending a login request to verify whether my credentials are working in the query parameter. If you're sending a large data request or a large payload, this cannot be achieved using the query parameter. This is because it has a length limitation of 2048 characters, so the entire payload or data is passed in the HTTP header. To send larger data, we recommend using the multipart or form data instead to send data that has a payload instead of the query parameter. In this case, the entire XML payload or data will be passed as a file or a payload in the given API example. Now, let's see both of this in our demo. First, we'll go to a system and verify whether the API is enabled. We'll go to Backup and Firmware, and then select the API tab. Within this section, we have the API configuration. You can check the box for API configuration or enable the API. You can then add the IP address from where you want to allow the API call request. Next, we'll go to authentication and create a new API admin user. I've already created the new API admin user with the appropriate read-write permissions. Let's proceed to the CLI and begin by making an API call using a query parameter. This is a simple API request to verify the authentication using a query parameter, where I'm using a curl command with the HTTP method type set to post. Let's make this request. We can see that the firewall responded with the successful method. This way, it's simple. You can also use this format to make other API requests, so long as they're supported by the firewall. To identify which API requests are supported by the firewall, you can hover over to the API documentation. Within here is a list of all the APIs which are supported by the firewall. Now, let's consider a slightly more complex example where we want to add a couple of IP address hosts. This time, we'll use a different option or method file option, supported by curl, to send these details as a payload. Let's explore the API documentation to see how to add an IP host. Navigate to System, Host and Services, Hosts, Add IP Hosts. You can see the XML payload format defined here, with all the tags defined. We can also see the tags that are mandatory, optional, and supported data types. Let's now navigate to the CLI. This time, we'll create a new file to add two new IP host objects. I've already created an XML file named add.xml, which contains the appropriate XML payload. You can see there is an outer tag which encompasses the login and set tag. The set tag is defined with the operation type add because we are creating two new IP host objects. In this example, I'm creating two new objects, a network and range object. Now, we'll use the curl command with the switch -f. We will specify the file name add.xml at the end. Submit the command and we'll have made the API request. The firewall has returned a successful response. Let's navigate to the UI and verify these objects have created successfully. Here we can see both objects were created with the appropriate details. Now, let's try to modify these two objects. To modify the request, we can again edit the add.xml and change the operation type as update in the set tag and modify the objects. Let's save the file and make the API request. We can see the firewall responded with success. Let's now remove these two objects. This time, we'll use different tags, one of which is the remove tag to remove both objects. I've already created remove.xml, which contains the request tag and remove tag with the name of both objects. Let's save the file and make the API request. Here, we see a successful response from the firewall. Let's navigate to the firewall and verify if the objects are removed. We'll refresh the page and search for demo. Let's now retrieve all the IP host objects. I've created a separate file, get.xml. The file contains the get tag with the name of the entity we want to retrieve. In this example, we want to retrieve all IP host objects. Let's save the file and make the API request. You can now see the firewall returned all the IP host objects present in the system. And that concludes how to get started with Sophos Firewall APIs. I hope you found this video useful. Let us know by giving us a thumbs up on TechVids if we resolved your issue. Check out the documentation for this video in the video description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techvids.sophos.com for more great videos like this one. Thanks for watching!